Sweep.
Okay, action.
Well, what are you fellas staring at? I'm not a pole dancer.
Gus, he's an old baseball scout.
Gus, you home?
No.
I guess that means I can come in.
Damn it.
Son of a bitch.
He's one of these guys who's very stubborn.
Some new kind of style I'm not up on.
That's Fang Shmei, don't you know anything?
Which I am perfectly capable of playing.
Gus believes in the old-fashioned way of doing things and doesn't really see much point in changing.
Gus Lobel's one of the best scouts baseball's ever seen. He's still got those intangibles you can't teach people. He knows talent.
My daughter can throw better than that.
He's been out there forever and he's starting to have a little trouble. We go back a long time. If something went wrong, you'd tell me, wouldn't you?
Of course. He may be ready for pasture.
For Christ's sakes, what is this?
Gus is my father, and I think that can be a challenging relationship.
Need some money for some new clothes?
I just came from yoga.
Looking into that voodoo, huh?
How's Mickey?
Good, they're gonna make her a partner at her firm, she thinks.
Pete reaches out to her and clues her into the fact that Gus is losing his sight.
If something goes wrong up in Carolina, he's gonna be out of a job.
She decides to go down and sort of watch out for her father.
Hey!
He should be back home.
If it makes you feel any better, I'm doing it for Pete.
Yeah, well, he's a horse's ass.
It must be so rewarding being one of your close friends.
Mickey and Gus are two people who focus in on their work to keep them from focusing in on everything else.
One of those for me?
Nope.
They have kind of a contentious thing. And he has a conflict that he doesn't want anybody to help. He doesn't want anybody feeling sorry for him.
I don't need your pointy little nose in my business.
Well, let me tell
you. Gus Lobel. Wow, it's good to see you, man.
This is my daughter, Mickey. Excuse us.
Sorry. Hi. I'm Mickey.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
You too. Okay.
Johnny comes into the film as another scout and comes a thread between Mickey and Gus.
How old was Mickey when
her mother died? 6.
How'd you handle all that by yourself?
I didn't.
Her father really seems to like this person, and I think that's what initially piques her curiosity.
Why are you right next to me?
Because you're the first scout I've ever been attracted to, thank God.
She just has this perfect storm of life events that make her sort of evaluate where she is and what's important to her for the rest of her life.
Where are you going?
I'm keeping a safe distance.
You're good at that.
Mickey and Johnny, I think they both offer up something that neither of them knew that they wanted.
You think you're pretty smart, don't you?
What, is that a good thing? You like smart?
Well, you gotta have it here and here.
Oh yeah, I'm pretty much what you're looking for then.
Johnny's character is really the catalyst that causes Mickey and Gus to face up to their issues.
I don't need your help. I don't know why you just don't go home.
Because I feel this dysfunctional sense of responsibility to make sure that you're okay.
Cut.
It's Rob's directorial debut, but there's nothing rookie about Rob.
He is steering the ship gracefully.
I've worked with Clint for almost 20 years. I started as an assistant director.
He was promoted in the middle of a picture in Bridges of Madison County.
Started with him so that I could observe and learn. And just about the time I was ready to move on, he asked me to start producing.
Oh, he's always wanted to direct, and I thought this is a perfect opportunity. Rob can direct. I'll just play a part, something I hadn't done for 20 years.
With a lot of first-time directors, they stumble a little bit. Rob, just by working with Clint for so many years, bypassed a lot of those initial stumbling blocks.
Observing the way Clint worked taught me to really embrace the collaboration and let everybody else contribute.
Thank you, that's great. Excellent.
He has a great knack, and he'll be doing other things.
So what do we do now?
Remember,
see the ball. Hit the ball.
I always love great personal relationship movies.
I don't think you quite expect the journey that it takes you on.
I think it's about second chances. You know too much about baseball to be a lawyer.
It's a long story.
I'd like to hear it.
I don't want to tell it.
Sometimes we have to let go of the life that we've created for ourselves in order to live a life we were meant to live.
I just didn't want you to have life in the cheap seats, Cecil.
They weren't the cheap seats. Spending every waking moment with my dad, those were the best seats in the house.